morning, Galileans. Welcome to this Sunday service. But I do have a few announcements this morning. In the back on the table are the midweek Lenten bulletins and the devotional books for the Lenten season. Those are meant for you to take home, so please grab one of those on your way out today if you haven't already done that. We have some birthdays this week. Lorna Whelan, Brad Bonin, Jeremy Swall, and Chad Shaw. We have anniversary, Tim and Vicki Whelan. Congratulations to all those folks. Are there any other prayer concerns for today? I'm sure there may be some from those of you that are viewing online, and we'll keep those in our thoughts as well. People of God, what is our mission? We are Galilean Lutheran Church, growing in, living out, and celebrating the grace and love of Christ Jesus our Lord. Would you please rise for the confession and forgiveness?
Good morning. I have a new headpiece, so we will see if that keeps us in volume so you can hear me. Let us begin by confessing our sins and hearing the words of forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. God hears us when we cry and draws us close in Jesus Christ. Let us return to the one who is full of compassion. Fountain of living water, pour out your mercy over us. Our sin is heavy and we long to be free. Rebuild what we have ruined and mend what we have torn. Wash us in your cleansing flood. Make us alive in the Spirit to follow the way of Jesus as healers and restorers of the world you so love. Amen. Beloved, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and the power of God, your sins are forgiven, and God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Amen. Our gathering song is We Are Called.
Am I alive, Mary?
Come live in the light. Shine with the joy and the love of the Lord. We are called to be light for the kingdom, to live in the freedom of the city of God. We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God. Come, open your heart. Show your mercy to all those who fear. We are called to be hope for the hopeless, so all hatred and blindness will be no more. We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God. Sing, sing a new song. Sing of the great day when all will be one. God will reign and will walk with each other, sisters and brothers, united in love. justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God.
The prayer of the day. Let us pray. Holy God, Heavenly Fathers, in the waters of the flood you saved the chosen, and in the wilderness of temptation you protected your Son from sin. Renew us in the gift of baptism. May your holy angels be with us, that the wicked foe may have no power over us, through Jesus Christ our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. The first reading is from Genesis chapter 9. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal on the earth with you. As many as came out of the ark, I establish my covenant with you that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the water shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I establish between me and all flesh that is in the earth." The word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 25. If we would read responsibly. "Your paths, O Lord, are steadfast love and faithfulness. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
My God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me.
Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me. For you are God of your salvation, and in you I have trusted all the day long.
Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love. For they are from everlasting.
Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your steadfast love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
You are gracious and upright, O Lord.
Therefore you teach sinners in your way. You lead the lowly in justice and teach the lowly your way.
All your paths, O Lord, are steadfast love and faithfulness.
To those who keep your covenant and your testimonies. The second reading is from first chapter of Peter. Christ also suffered for the sins once for all, the righteousness for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which is prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of the dirt from your body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authority, and powers made subject to him." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
please stand for the gospel?
One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan. And he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Grace to you and peace from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. As I prepared for my sermon this week, I had this feeling of deja vu. Didn't we just read these verses? Am I looking at the right text? You see, verses 4 through 11 were read on the baptism of our Lord, and verses 14 through 20 were read on Epiphany 3. And now for this first Sunday in Lent, we read 9 through 15, hearing verses 12 and 13 for the first time, the verses of temptation. These verses fit well with the theme of Lent 1, the temptation of Christ, Jesus testing in the wilderness. And unlike Matthew and Luke, who tell the story of Jesus testing in 11 to 13 verses, Mark, in his succinct style, devotes two verses with very little detail. Yet, taken as a whole, Mark tells us quite a bit about Jesus' experience in the wilderness. Jesus, filled with the Holy Spirit from his baptism, is driven by that same Spirit into the wilderness. Something is about to happen, something to which we need to pay attention. At his baptism in the River Jordan, Jesus comes out of the water. The heavens are torn apart, and the Spirit descends like a dove. Jesus alone hears the voice from heaven, announced to him that he is God's Son, the Beloved. The Spirit enters Jesus. God has come down from heaven. God is on the loose on earth. And then we hear Mark's key word throughout his gospel, immediately. Immediately Jesus is driven into the wilderness. Immediately Jesus is cast out, thrown out into the wilderness, and tested by Satan. Immediately he is cast out into the wilderness with the wild beasts. The wilderness is a place of testing. And 40 days is reminiscent of the 40 years of Israel wandering in the wilderness, being tested by God. The wilderness is a place and time of testing. And the Greek word can be translated testing or tempted. In the NRSV, it is translated tempted. But other times, you will see it translated testing. So what would be the difference between using the word tested or tempting? What is happening that Jesus is now out in the wilderness? In a test, a tester is trying to determine if the testee knows what they can or cannot do. Any teachers out there? Done a lot of tests to figure out whether your students are grasping the information. In a temptation, the tempter is trying to make the temptee fail. As a teacher, we keep telling our students, we're not trying to fail you, we're trying to figure out what you know. Tests are to help testees discover what they know and what they can do. And with a young driver in the house now, with driver's ed was about learning what you know and don't know and how you can improve your driving skills. We know also that doctors and nurses and lawyers and many occupations require a test so that those doctors and lawyers have a minimum amount of knowledge so that we can safely use their services. Testing is good. It's about knowledge. And it is in times of testing that we grow. We grow in our times of testing with trust in God. Through difficult times, we trust in God and we realize that our faith can grow. We strengthen our Christian character as we learn to trust in God. However, Satan has another purpose during our trials. Satan's purpose is to turn the testee, to turn us away from God, to tempt us to sin, to do what is wrong. That is how testing and tempting differ. What does it mean to tempt? To tempt is to try to convince someone to do something that they know is not right, that they should not do. To willingly change, to change the person's will to do what is wrong. To tempt is to entice someone to want to do something that they know is wrong, but what's the problem with doing it? You see, tempters can't make someone do something bad, but they can try to make a person want to do something bad despite knowledge to the contrary. The tempter doesn't take away the will, but rather changes the will. The testee decides willingly to do what they should not do. Satan didn't make Adam and Eve eat the fruit. Satan changed their will to do what God said not to do. They changed from this is wrong to what's the harm in it. And Satan in our text today can't make Jesus turn against God. Jesus' will does not change to his will to do as God desires while in the desert, in the wilderness. Satan did not win. Satan could not and did not change Jesus' will for God, Jesus' will to do God's will on earth for humanity, for creation. The image of Jesus with the wild beasts in the wilderness. Wild beasts and harm. Jesus, in the wilderness, we have another image of Jesus in harm's way. The wilderness that we know from the Old Testament, from Israel's past, is a place of testing. And in Isaiah, we hear the passage, when the new Messiah comes, when the Messiah comes, the wolf shall live with a lamb. Jesus is in the wilderness with the wild beasts and is not harmed. Might this be the sign of the coming kingdom, a new world order? Another character in those two lines are the angels. God's messengers are with Jesus, ministering to him, serving him. He who came to serve is being served by the angels in the wilderness. What great images we have in these two little verses. Verse where the Spirit descends forcing Jesus into the wilderness, a scary place, where Satan will tempt him, where the wild beasts are found, and where the angels keep Jesus safe. It's a frightening place, but God is with him. Having been tested, Jesus returns to Galilee, proclaiming the good news. The kingdom of God is near. Repent and believe. The season of Lent is about repentance and believing in the one God who sent his Son to die for our sins. We keep believing. We keep repenting during this season of Lent, a season where we watch Jesus take the path to the cross willingly. Jesus follows God's will. And along that path, there will be those who try to take him away from the path, steer him a different direction from the cross. But in the test, Jesus follows the Father's will. And his resolve to walk to that cross grows stronger, and his faith and his sight is set on Jerusalem to carry out the mission of the Father. Along the way, we see that Jesus, who came to serve, has his needs met in service as well. So we begin this Lenten season with an image of the heavens being torn open as the boundary between heaven and earth are opened. God's Spirit has entered God's Son. God is now on the loose. God walks with us. God is one of us in human form. And Lent will end with Jesus' crucifixion. And at his crucifixion in the Jerusalem temple, the curtain will be torn from top to bottom. The curtain that kept the people away, that kept God in a holy place. God's holy presence, which was once sanctioned off from the people, God's holy presence with the tearing of the curtain will be let loose in the world. Jesus is a boundary breaker. In his baptism, the heavens are torn open, and at his death, the curtain that separates God from the people is torn. Through Jesus' death and resurrection, God and humankind now have contact. God has come down from heaven and is walking among us. Keep on believing God is with us. Keep on repenting, for through Christ, we have a relationship with the God of heaven and earth. There are no boundaries, for God walks with us. Amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet I'll forever be wandering. Jesus, be my guide. Hold me to your side. I will love you to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Please rise as we profess the creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. In Jesus, your realm has come near to us every place and time. Give your church throughout the world a spirit of humility and repentance. Teach us to trust always in the good news of your salvation. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You have made a covenant of mercy with every living creature. Protect all the earth's creatures from destruction. Empower the work of biologists, conservationists, and science educators. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy
is great. All your paths are steadfast love and faithfulness. Direct the words and actions of our leaders in our communities and throughout the world, that they may maintain justice for the lowly. Hear us, O God.
Your
mercy is great. Even in the wilderness, you are with us. Walk alongside the migrants and refugees crossing dangerous lands. Tend to those whose lives feel desolate. Give healing and strength to all those who suffer. Especially we pray for Lori Juergen's mother, Nia Lu's mother, Kim, Ruth Topp's mother-in-law, Mary Lou, Barb Gettle, Lincoln, Mike, Larry and Lorraine Hoffman, Tom, Blair Smith, for Stephanie Fatlin, Mary Lee Fatlin, for Ron and Sonny Stevenson, for Kim Kapinski's parents and Beckett, for Sally Christensen. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy
is great. In the covenant of baptism, you claim us as beloved children. Nurture us to our baptismal identity and teach us to live within it for its sake of others. Strengthen this congregation's ministry of care and concern. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Bless Caleb, Jacob and Caleb. Keep them safe as they serve to protect our nation and preserve the freedoms we hold dear. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In baptism, you join us to the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. We praise you for all those who have died trusting in your faithfulness. Bring us with them to the fullness of your reign. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always,
and also with you. The peace of Christ be with you all. Let us pray. Faithful God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal, that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Give thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray as our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus draws the whole world to himself. Come to this meal and be fed. You may be seated. Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us into the power of your Spirit, that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new. In Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And now a blessing. You are what God made you to be, created in Christ Jesus for good works, chosen as holy and beloved, freed to serve your neighbor. God bless you, that you may be a blessing. In the name of the Holy and life-giving Trinity, amen. Our sending song is "Precious Lord, Take My Hand."
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, take me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the light draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.